Hello everyone, in the last video, I introduced how to install driver for Ezcad. In this video, we will do some basic settings in the software. First, we click the small range icon. Then we click workspace, check the show workspace option. Then we set the size of workspace. The working area of my machine is 110 by 110 millimeters, so I input 110 here. We also need to set the two parameters. They are minus 55. This number is the half of the size value. If the working area of your machine is 200, then you should input 200 here and input minus 100 here. If you don't know the work area of your machine, you can check the numbers printed on your lens. The 1064 is the wavelength. The working area of my lens is 112. Then we click F3. We set field size to 110 here. And we set gimbal 2 equals X here. We choose the second option, gimbal center. Then we switch to laser control. The laser type, we choose fiber, and the laser source type. Because I have a recurse laser source, so I choose recurse. If you have a GPT laser source, you can choose GPT. If you have a GPT MOPA laser source, you should check this option, enable pathways. If you have a max laser source, you can choose IPG. Then import. If you have a pedal, you should choose the import number. There are 16 numbers. Different machines have different settings. If you don't know the import number of your machine, then you can test them one by one. We need also check the pulse mode option 2. Then we can make a test. Okay, if you are satisfied with the marking result, then you can stop here. You don't need to watch the following video. If you have higher requirement on the accuracy of the marking or the red light, you can watch the following video. We draw a square. The size is 100 by 100. We'll mark on the black test paper. If you don't have the black paper, you can use the black printing paper instead. You can see the two sides are distorted. They are curves, not lines. And the size is not correct. We can fix these problems in the software. First, we fix the distortion problem. There are two sets of parameters. One set is the parameters of gimbal 1. Another is the parameters for gimbal 2. we can fix the distortion problem with the two parameters. The parameter range is from 0.875 to 1.125. The rule is that if the marking result like this type, we should increase the given tool parameter. If the marking result is like this type, then we need to lower the given tool parameter. If you remember, the marking shape is more like this one, so we need to increase the given tool parameter. Given tool parameter, we increase it to 1.1, for example. And do marking test. You can see the marking result is more like this type. So we need to lower the parameter. We change it to 1.05 and do marking test. The left and the right sides are straighter now. We can check with the ruler and see if they are still a little concave or convex. Then we can continue to adjust the parameters. Finally, I got the best parameter. Then I adjust this parameter with the same method. The rule is that if the marking result looks like this type, the upper and lower sides are convex, then we need to increase the given one parameter. If the upper and lower sides are concave into the box, then we need to lower the parameter. Finally, I got the best parameter, 0.975. Then we do marking test. Now the four sides are straight lines. We know the size is not correct. We can calibrate the size with the scales. We can click this icon. We can input the size we want in the Go Mark size box and input the actual mark size in the real mark size box. Then we measure the marking size first. The size of upper and lower sides are 110 millimeters. The size of left and right sides are 118 millimeters. We set given tool equals X, so we can calibrate the size of the upper and lower sides with this scale. The size we want is 100. The real mark size is 110. We can calibrate the size of the left and the right side with this scale. The real mark size is 118. Okay, and mark. Okay, the size is correct now. Sometimes the red preview box doesn't match the marking perfectly. We can align them in the software. We click F3, other, red light pointer. We can adjust the size of the red light with the two parameters. We can adjust the position of the red light with the two parameters. For example, if we change the size scale Y to a larger number, the preview box becomes larger in Y direction. If we use a smaller number, the box becomes smaller in Y direction. If we set offset position Y to a positive number, the red preview box moves up. If we input a negative number, the red preview box moves downwards. Okay, finally I got the best parameters. Take screenshots and save them in your computer in case you forget them. Okay, we finished the settings. If you have any question about Ezcad settings or laser marking machine, leave a comment and I will answer them. Thank you.